Hello there, my fellow squadmates and tank drivers, and welcome back to one of our oldest series from Warhammer 40k lore. The series is none other than Imperial Guard Vehicles, and although I probably told you more than once now that it is almost over, there is still quite a bit of life left in it. So for today's topic, we're gonna talk about a couple of Imperial Guard tank hunters which I didn't cover before. The Valdor Tank Hunter and the Destroyer Tank Hunter. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? The Valdor Tank Hunter is a heavy tank destroyer, named after the legendary Emperor's Legio Custodes commander, none other than Constantine Valdor. This thing was only just entering service with the Exertus Imperialis in limited number and on a trial basis when the Horus Heresy began. Initial production runs were channeled to the elite Solar Auxilia, in particular to those cohorts operating against foes equipped with heavy tanks, or in the case of the Xenos still infesting the stars, analogs of tanks. While utilizing a familiar chassis on which several other armored vehicles in the arsenal of the Solar Auxilia were based, the Valdor mounted a devastating neutron laser. Each one of these was a meticulously wrought iteration of a then-recently recovered relic from the Dark Age of Technology. While not yet in common use, at the time, the Imperial logisticians had projected that its services were likely to be required in even greater numbers. This was especially the case when loyalist Solar Auxilia were called upon to fight the traitor Legiones Astartes, and the heavy armored vehicles that they had access to. Ancient records found at the Scholastica Bellicose on the planet Mordia show that a Valdor Tank Hunter was most widely used during the Great Scouring after the Heresy, when the Imperium led their great counterattack against the traitor legions, driving them all the way to the Eye of Terror. In the 41st millennium, the Valdor Tank Hunter is considered an ancient relic, with the number of forge worlds able to maintain, let alone construct them, dwindling to just a handful. As a result, they are rarely utilized among the Imperial Guard armored regiments. The 1st Cadian Armored Regiment, which helped defend the Imperial Fortress World of Cadia in the past, possesses a grand total of 5 Valdors. During the Siege of Vrax, the 88th Siege Army's intelligence officers believed that there were no more than 30 of them stored inside Vrax Prime's vast Departamento Minotaurum storehouses, and these tanks were not utilized by the traitor militia until much later in the conflict. It is also believed that a Dark Magos of the Dark Mechanicum arrived on the planet with the Steel Brethren Chaos Space Marines, and helped the Renegades activate and deploy the Valdor tanks in the Vraxian storehouses. The payment for the Dark Mechanicums for this help was the provision of several fully functional Valdor tank hunters, and what is believed to be a data core detailing how to construct them. This means, unfortunately, that there is a dreadful possibility that the Valdor tank hunters may start appearing in the armies of the Forces of Chaos in the near future. The Valdor is armed with the ancient weapon known as the Neutron Laser Projector, which was developed during the Dark Age of Technology, and thus very few Forge Worlds are still able to manufacture or maintain them. The weapon does take up most of the space inside the tank, and the shielding required for its power generator is not very thick, so any major damage caused by an enemy attack could have disastrous consequences for the crew. If the weapon fails to transfer all the energy into its target while firing, it could also lead to a powerful feedback reaction that can damage the weapon itself. The Valdor is also equipped with a single sponson-mounted heavy flamer, but this can be replaced by a heavy stubber, heavy bolter, autocannon, or las cannon. The tank can also be equipped with a hunter-killer missile launcher, a pintle-mounted heavy stubber or storm bolter, extra armor plating, a searchlight, a dozer blade, or smoke launchers. Some statistics for this thing include: there's only 2 known patterns. Its crew consists of 1 commander, 1 driver, 2 gunners, and 1 engineer. Its power plant is a HL330 V12 multi-fuel. It weighs 96 tons. Its length is 11.5 meters, or 37.7 feet. Its width is 4.9 meters, or 16.07 feet. Its height is 3.7 meters, or 12.1 feet. Its maximum speed on road is 25 kilometers an hour. Its maximum speed off-road is 18 kilometers an hour. The superstructure armor is 180 millimeters, and the hull armor is 160 millimeters. Secondly for today, we have the Destroyer Tank Hunter. This destroyer tank of the Imperial Guard is a true relic. It was once a commonly employed Imperial tank on the battlefield, but nowadays they are few and far between in the Imperial Guard's order of battle. The tank is equipped with a powerful weapon known as a heavy laser destroyer, and do make excellent tank hunters. However, due to the painstakingly complex task of building each weapon, and the very few forge worlds that remain still capable of manufacturing and maintaining them, there are fewer and fewer of these tanks deployed across the Imperium. The Imperial Guard units that do have any of these tanks in their possession guard them jealously, and take great care to ensure that they are always patched and repaired after every conflict they participate in. If one is lost during battle, it is a high priority to salvage what remains. For while the main gun is almost irreplaceable, the hull can be repaired and refitted with other weaponry. Like mentioned earlier, the Destroyer Tank Hunter is equipped with a powerful weapon known as a Heavy Laser Destroyer, which is capable of destroying almost any other armored unit in one hit. This main weapon is offset to the left side of the vehicle, giving it increased ability and making the overall size of the tank smaller and harder to target. This also allows both the tank commander and the gunner to use the weapon sights. This tank is built using the common Mars Alpha tank chassis, simply modified by removing the turret ring and replacing it with a crew hatch and two internal maintenance hatches. Due to the readily available spare parts for the tank, this allows salvage wrecks to be repaired and retrofitted with other weapons, while the unit awaits a replacement for the heavy laser destroyer, which, unfortunately, may never come in their lifetime. The tank is able to be equipped with other war gear like camouflage netting, extra armor plating, improved communications gear, a minesweeper, a pintle-mounted heavy stubber, storm bolter, rough terrain modifications, track guards and smoke launchers. The Destroyer Tank Hunter is an excellent anti-armor vehicle, capable of sniping away enemy tanks from a great distance and then moving to another location and repeat. Although the tanks are not useful during a direct assault or a close range engagement due to their lack of a rotating turret or secondary weaponry, it is best deployed out of the way of danger, at the rear of the unit so it can take advantage of its long range accuracy. Some notable users of the Destroyer Tank Hunter include the 8th Pardus Armored Regiment, the 5th Deneb Armored Regiment, the 142nd Cadian Armored Regiment, the 8th Valhallan Armored Regiment, the 46th Palladius Armored Regiment, the 7th Dnieper Tank Corps, the 9th Dnieper Tank Corps, the 13th Wallstadt Armored Regiment, the 21st Death Corps of Krieg Panzer Division, and the 2nd Pyresian Armored Regiment. Some statistics for this thing include: there are 9 known patterns. Its crew consists of 1 commander, 1 driver, and 1 gunner. Its power plant is an MR-230 V12 multi-fuel. It weighs 52 tons. Its length is 7.08 meters, or 23.2 feet. Its width is 4.86 meters, or 15.9 feet. Its height is 3.4 meters, or 11.1 feet. Its maximum speed on road is 50 kilometers an hour. Its maximum speed off-road is 36 kilometers an hour. The superstructure armor is 200 millimeters. The hull armor is 150 millimeters. And the gun mantlet is 150 millimeters. Now, while not exactly a tank hunter itself, the Thunderer Siege Tank is basically a version of the Destroyer, so I thought to add this in the episode too. The Thunderer was developed as a field conversion sometime in the 38th millennium by a Departamentum Unitorum field workshop as a replacement for a lost Lehman Russ demolisher. Using the destroyer Tank Hunter chassis and a spare demolisher cannon, the field workshop was able to quickly replace the lost Lehman Russ demolishers. Due to the advanced technology used in the heavy laser destroyer of the destroyer Tank Hunter being very difficult to repair and costly to manufacture, there are many unused destroyer tank chassis which can, thankfully, be refitted with a demolisher cannon. After stripping out the laser destroyer and its capacitors and batteries, and installing the demolisher cannon in its place, there is, unfortunately, only room for 18 rounds. And thus, this tank cannot operate for a long period of time. It is produced at Forge Worlds, which cannot manufacture the heavy laser destroyer. As the Thunderer Siege Tank is a replacement vehicle, it is usually not included in any known Imperial unit's order of battle. This tank is armed with a single forward-firing demolisher cannon and nothing else. It has extra armor added to its dorsal surface due to its need for protection from enemies who have fortified themselves within tall buildings in urban combat. Just like its parent design, it can be outfitted with a pintle-mounted heavy stubber, camo netting, hunter-killer missile launcher, minesweeper, dozer blade, searchlights, and all the other good stuff. Another unnamed variant of the Thunderer is also known to exist, which instead of a demolisher cannon is equipped with a battle cannon or a vanquisher cannon, and it is used by armored regiments when they lack an adequate number of functioning Lehman Russ tanks. Some notable users of the Thunderer include the 8th Pardus Armored Regiment, the 8th Necromundan Regiment, the Armageddon Steel Legion, the 18th Catacan Jungle Fighters Regiment, the 21st Death Corps of Krieg Panzer Division, the 21st Palladius Armored Regiment, the 4th Vashtat Independent Tank Regiment, the Skitari Mars Regiments, the 17th Talarn Armored Regiment, and the 179th Death Corps of Krieg Regiment. Since this thing is based on the destroyer chassis, the stats for it are pretty much identical, so I'm not gonna mention them again. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about these tank hunters, the Valdor and the Destroyer, for today. Is either of these among your favorite Imperial Guard vehicles? What do you like or dislike most about them? As always, you can share your thoughts and opinions in the comments below. Was the episode informative or entertaining? In that case, please click the like button and subscribe for future content. If you want to support the channel so I can continue making these videos, you can also visit my Patreon page, the link for which is in the video description. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and I wish you all an awesome and peaceful day. The Emperor protects.